Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT math section. The problem that you see on your screen right now is taken from the third practice test in the new SAT study guide dedicated to the redesigned SAT that will start from March of 2016, right? The official new SAT study guide. Practice test 3, section 3, problem number 20, no calculator. Okay, so in triangle ABC, the measure of angle B is 90 degrees, BC is equal to 16, and AC is equal to 20. Triangle DEF is similar to triangle ABC, where vertices D, E, and F correspond to vertices A, B, and C respectively. And each side of triangle DEF is 1/3 the length of the corresponding side of triangle ABC. What is the value of sine F? Right, so the first thing I would do if I had scratch paper, you see I drew it for you, I would draw similar triangles because we're told that the triangle DEF is similar to triangle ABC, right, and draw it correctly because in the triangle ABC, angle B measures 90 degrees, so it's a right triangle, right, and when you're dealing with trigonometry, you must have right triangles, right, so, and after that you can draw the similar triangle DEF, right, with also and it says vertices D, E, and F correspond to vertices A, B, and C. So that means that angle E is also 90 degrees, right, for the triangle DEF. Now it says that each side of the triangle DEF is 1/3 the length of the corresponding side of triangle ABC, right? So we know the side lengths of DF and FE, but we don't need that, and I'll explain to you why we don't need to deal with this triangle that much. So the first thing that you should realize that since these two triangles are similar, first of all, what is the value of sine F? The sine F will be opposite over hypotenuse, right? What is the opposite side to this angle F? The opposite side is DE, right? Because the adjacent is FE, and this is the hypotenuse, the longest side, which is the opposite side of the 90 degree angle, right? In every right triangle, hypotenuse is an opposite side to the 90 degree angle, right? So the opposite side to angle F is DE. So that means similarly, the opposite side to angle C is AB. Right, so that means that AB divided by AC is going to be the same as DE divided by DF, right? Because each side is proportionally larger relative to each side of the second triangle, right? These two triangles are similar. So that means sine of C will be the same value as sine of F, right? Because since DE is proportionally smaller than AB and DF is proportionally smaller within the same proportion than AC, that means DE divided by DF will be the same value as AB divided by AC. So that means we can actually disregard this triangle and work with this triangle to find the value of sine F, because we're also looking for sine C, which is the same thing, right? So this leads us to know that, to deduct that sine C is equal to sine F, and that means that AB, the only unknown side, will be divided by 20. So all we need is the value of AB to find the value of sine F. Right, so to find AB, we're given BC and AC, right? So we can use Pythagorean theorem to find the missing side. Now, since you know that AB squared plus 16 squared will be 20 squared, that means AB will be 20 squared minus 16 squared inside the square root, right? Because AB is not squared, we took the square root, so if, and since the sides must be positive, we don't have plus minus, right? So it's going to be 20 squared minus 16 squared. And you should know this immediately. I mean, you can perform multiplication for 16 if you don't remember, but you should memorize the squares for these simple numbers, because 20 squared, that's easy, that's 400, and 16 squared is 256, right? You should memorize these things, right? So 400 minus 256, you might say, oh, but what about the resultant? How do I know the square root? And there's no square root allowed in this kind of question, because this is a fill-in question for section 3. Well, you're in luck, because 400 minus 256 is 144, and the square root of 144 is exactly 12. So AB measures 12 units. So now we can easily find the value of sine C, which is 12 divided by 20, right? The opposite side divided by the hypotenuse, which is 20, right? So 12 over 20, and that could be simplified. Remember, you need to provide the simplest answer, which is, and you use the greatest common factor of 20 and 12, which is going to be 4, right? So you divide both the numerator and the denominator by 4, and you get on top, you get 3 for the numerator, and for the denominator, the simplified denominator, you get 5, right? So 3/5 is the correct answer that you would grid in on the answer sheet, or you can write in 0.6, right? 6/10, in other words.